Good evening and welcome to this short service of reflections and prayers, which is being held for the first time on Sunday evening. For the past five Sundays, we've been celebrating the season of creation, and today we reach the climax as we remember and give thanks for the life of St. Francis of Assisi. This is a live Zoom service and is being recorded and will soon be available, I hope, on YouTube for others. And details of our services for the next few days are in the new news sheets called The Week Ahead, which can be viewed and downloaded from the church website. As we go through this order of service, please join in whenever you see certain words highlighted in bold. And now let's collect our thoughts for a moment before we begin. Blessed are you, Lord God, creator of heaven and earth. Your word calls all things into being, and the light of dawns awakens us to life. May your wisdom guide us, that we may cherish and care for your good creation, and offer to you the sacrifice of our lips, praising you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, let us pray with one heart and mind. As our evening prayer rises before you, O God, so may your mercy come down upon us to cleanse our hearts and set us free to sing your praise now and forever. Amen. A reading from the Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 12. Maybe next week someone would like to have this in advance and read for us rather than me doing everything. It's good to have different voices. Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or about your body, what you will wear. For life is more than food and the body more than clothes. Consider the ravens. They do not sow or reap. They have no storeroom or barn, yet God feeds them. And how much more valuable are you than birds? Who of you, by worrying, can add a single hour to your life? Since you cannot do this very little thing, why do you worry about the rest? Consider how the wild flowers grow. They do not labour or spin. Yet I tell you, not even Solomon in all his splendor was dressed like one of these. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today and tomorrow is thrown into the fire, how much more will he clothe you, you of little faith? And do not set your heart on what you will eat or drink. Don't worry about it, for the pagan world runs after all such things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them. But seek his kingdom, and all these things will be given to you as well. Do not be afraid, little flock, for your Father has been pleased to give you the kingdom. Sell your possessions and give to the poor. Provide purses for yourselves that will not wear out, a treasure in heaven that will never fail, where no thief comes near and no moth destroys. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And now we're going to try and sing together, well, at least in the privacy of our own rooms.
Thank you.
Well, I'm going to go on now and give you a short reflection about St. Francis. He was born about 800 years ago in Assisi in Italy, the son of a wealthy merchant. And as a young man, Francis led a worldly, carefree life. An early biographer said, he squandered his time terribly. Indeed, he outshone all his friends in trivialities. In the year 1202, he marched off to battle against the city of Perugia, full of a young man's dreams of military glory. But he was taken prisoner during the battle, and a year later, his father had to arrange a ransom to get him back. And that was followed by a year's convalescence in Assisi, during which he had a fever, a year in which Francis, now in his early 20s, was gradually being transformed. During his illness, Francis experienced dreams and visions. One day, as he prayed in a dilapidated church in San Domingo at the edge of Assisi, he heard Christ say three times from the crucifix, "Francis, go repair my house, which, as you can see, is falling completely to ruin." Francis believed God was asking him to repair the physical walls and roof of the church that he'd been praying in. It was only some time later that his followers realized God's call had a spiritual dimension to the church of people. And so Francis began raising money by selling off the family belongings. Well, this didn't go down very well with his father. And when he realized what was happening without his permission, he became furious and called on the local bishop to discipline his son, as well as repaying all the money. And during his public trial, Francis shocked everyone by completely removing all his clothes and laying them neatly in a pile in front of his father, and then walking calmly out of the city. Well, one day in a church, he heard from the Gospel of Matthew, "Take no gold or silver or copper in your wallet, no bag for your journey, nor two tunics, nor sandals, nor a staff." And Francis took this teaching literally as he began an itinerant lifestyle. He lived in utter simplicity and preached a strong gospel calling sinners to repent. By the year 1209, Francis had attracted a dozen men who wanted to share his life and ministry. So he went to Rome and asked the Pope for permission to start an order of friars who, unlike monks, venture out into the world sharing God's love with everyone they happen to meet. Sure enough, the Pope gave his blessing and Francis was appointed leader of this small band of brothers. Well, that's just a very brief summary of a rich and amazing life, but I wonder what difference Francis' example could make to us. So I've got a few ideas to share with you. Maybe you'll have some of your own, which we can hear about later. Well, you may remember that Francis had a change of heart whilst convalescing from warfare and illness. And during this period, he renounced his ambitions for wealth and status, turning instead towards poverty, chastity, and obedience. And surely our Western society could learn something from Francis. I can't see how we can keep on consuming the earth's resources at such an unsustainable rate. And surely we too need to find more fulfillment in our spiritual lives and be less materialistic. Well, the next point that comes to mind is that Francis thought God wanted him to rebuild the walls of the ruined church. And it was later that he realized God was calling him to rebuild the Roman Catholic Church across Europe. And in the same way, we too can become rather too preoccupied with our physical buildings, our hymn books, our money, our place on committees and rotas, whatever it may be. Surely God is calling most of us to look outwards and to seek God's kingdom in our local neighbourhood, to work with the parish councils, for example. Finally, when God turned Francis' life around, he became not only a great evangelist, but also a great admirer and advocate for God's creation. And we in Gloucester Diocese are trying to encourage parish churches like ours in the Churn Valley to become more environmentally responsible. And I'm very pleased that at Elkstone and Stratton, they've achieved awards for the Eco Church scheme. And I'd love the same to happen elsewhere. So finally, let's round off that little talk with the collect for today. O God, you ever delight to reveal yourself to the childlike and lowly of heart. Grant that, following the example of Blessed Francis, we may count the wisdom of this world as foolishness and know only Jesus Christ and him crucified, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So now we come to our prayers, which are pretty much in the usual format that you'll be familiar with. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the wonderful things you've created on the earth. We're sorry that so often we take your creation for granted and even go as far as to abuse it. We pray for the wild creatures and those that are domesticated as well, asking that you'll be with them in their struggle for survival and shelter them from the dangers that surround them, especially from over-exploitation by people like us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Dear Lord, we thank you for the almost infinite variety of insects, fish, birds, and animals that you have created. We're especially grateful for those animals and plants that are part of the human food chain. And we are sad that industrial farming methods and intensive fishing have inflicted so much suffering and permanent loss of so many unique species. Have mercy on us and help us to change our ways. On a lighter note, we do thank you for domestic pets that share our homes and lives and for all the companionship they give us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, our Creator, we thank you for the gift of life with all its blessings and sorrows. We ask that you'll be close to those who will be born in this next 24 hours or so, as well as those who are destined to die, that joining with the company of all your saints, we may rejoice in one unending song of praise. May those who are sorrowful know your comfort, and those who are joyful know your protection. We pray at this time particularly for Adrian and Lisa Hill, for Clarice Vaughan, Andrea Schutt, Donald Newell and Tim Shand. And now a moment of silence as we remember others who we want to bring into God's presence. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O Lord, our God, we ask that you'd accept these prayers in your tender mercy. Look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, and we give you all the glory. Through Christ our Saviour. Amen. And now shall we close in the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And now may the blessing of the living God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.